You don't know how to dance. Okay. Hi guys, welcome to Faulu TV. Welcome to another video. Guys, it is store time.
Okay, today we're gonna talk about identity theft. So this story comes at the right time because they just closed the states, not the state, the whole of they just closed the DV 2023 application, that is the green card application, and now most people applied out there. If you apply, we wish you the best. We hope you win. But do you know winning? It's the start of a good life to some, and it will be a start of wars to some, but we don't want you to get through the bad part of it. We want to try and enlighten you before you get there, you know? You know what you're going through. So, when you come here, we talk about identity theft. Identity theft. Here, it's like your identity is your life. So when you come, you get a green card. After a green card, that's before you get to the job world. There's very essential document that you need to have to go and work anywhere, genuinely. And they give you a social security number. It's different from your ID number, and that everything, your life is tied to that number. Anywhere you go to apply for a job, if you apply for a loan, they want to know that number. And people steal that number. If someone steals your ID, that number, you don't have to steal the ID. You know what some people do? You can just take a photo, keep it, and then you use it. That person takes part of your life. So it's good timing, I would say, because one of our viewers emailed. We have an email address at faulutvinc@gmail.com. So she texted us and she said she would love to have us talk about this topic and enlighten people on how people get, what people go through if someone steals those things. So I think my friend here can read the email because I think you have it. Read it to them.
Hi guys, this lady emailed saying, "Hi Faulu, I've been watching you guys, I've been following you guys. When I came to America, I went through hell. And I don't want nobody to go through what I went through. Please, can you guys talk about this?" And when we look at the email, we're like, "Oh yeah, why not? That's what everybody's going through." So she said she came to US. Her name is, she didn't want to say her name. She said, she gave us her name and she said, "Please don't mention my name." But one time she says she'll come to our channel to give her life channel story. She said, "My name is so and so. I came to America. I was very young lady. I was 23 years old when I came. My sister hosted me. I trusted my bad sister. We all trusted our partners." She said, "I trusted my bad sister. I gave it everything to her. She came, she picked me from the airport. She did whatever she was supposed to do. She hosted me. I get my first job working, went to school as a CNA. She finished as CNA. She was working and she was thinking there are good times with her sister. She was helping with the kids in the house and everything. She didn't see anything wrong or hand complaints. She thought her sister was, they were good friends. Until one time I went to apply for the green card. No, sorry. One time I went to apply for the credit card. When I went to the bank, they asked me for my ID, my information. I didn't know what that is. So I went home. The following day, I went to my sister and I said, my sister was the one always keeping the documents. One day, I went back home and asked my sister to give me the ID so I can take it to the bank and apply for the loan. A little bit, my sister denied it to give it to me, but finally she gave it to me. I went to the bank, I give them my social, give them my ID. When they looked up, they told me I have 15,000
RON. That's US dollars loan, which you don't know of, which you don't, because you don't know paying. You don't know any loan. Well, what will you be paying for?
She says, she continues, she's not done. It's a shocking story though. She said, I was shocked. I didn't know what to do. I have no words to say. And then I cried for a little bit. The officer who helped me that day, he was very kind, very calm. He talked to me and they said, ask me a few questions to help me find out who is using my documents. The only person that could come on my mind was my sister because she was the one who's having my documents. I never stay with anybody. So, if it were you, what would you do?
That's so sad.
Very sad.
That's so sad because when you have blood sisters, I would talk about relatives and not just far relatives, close relatives, because if you have like your sister, your brother, you tend to trust them. Your trust on your brother and your sister is on a higher level than to anyone else until that person does something to you for you to trust him or her less. So by you grabbing your sister over and trusting her with everything, all those years, you go to work, you get a job. After you get a job, you return the document to her like she owns the document. So that's
and she says she was even doing shopping in the house. When she gets paid, she go shopping.
And that's the same her. One sister.
And she help even the kids. The sister was a widow, they call. Then she say my sister was a widow. Then she was helping in the house. She felt for her sister. She wasn't babysitting and sister goes to work. She feels like this is my bad sister. I need to help her. But at the end of the day, guess how she get a gift back.
Yeah, so
that happens a lot.
Yeah,
it has happened here in America. So please, guys, please, when you come with your documents, be extra careful. Whoever is hosting you, do not trust nobody when it comes to your documents. Yes, the host is gonna know your information.
Yeah, because when you come, number one, remember you don't have an address. When you go to apply for those documents, the reason you apply for those documents when you're here in America is because you need to give them an address, an existing address. So what happens is you give them your address where you're living. So the address comes addressed to you. The mail comes addressed to you, but in the owner of the house's address.
Mm-hmm.
So, and the person who usually, mostly the people who can access the box is the owner of the house. And you can access, but you know what? You have to have your horns down when you go to have someone's house. Be humble. The owner of the house will get the mail and give it to you. And the email, the envelope is sealed so tight that you can tell if someone opens it and closes it. So when you receive it, check it. If it looks like it's been opened, don't be too harsh to judge, you know. Just keep it, but know, new. I need to be extra careful because I don't know who opened it. I don't want to cause any chaos, but your trust level with your personal documents should be very high. You should trust. That's the only document. You should not be lying anyhow with anyone because it's not even your sister. It's not even the person you're staying with. You can go somewhere, even at work, and you drop it, and someone can just snap a photo of the two. And guess
and that's
what?
It.
That person will be shopping using your name.
And that loan is on you.
Either you pay or you take this person to collections.
And you have to prove it.
What happens is when it's brat sister, what does your parent tell you?
Not even that. The rent didn't finish there. So we emailed back and forth. I asked her, so tell me the story. What did you do? So what did you do? She said after that she went home. So he was crying, and then you know the officer kind of comforted her. The only person came on her mind was her sister. So she went home and talked to the sister, and then asking her, I went to the bank, and this is what happened.
You're going back to her house.
You have no choice. You have no choice. You have to go to the same house.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's your sister. You have to go to the same house. So she went and explained to the sister and said, telling the sister why she went to the bank, how are they went, what happened, and what information she have. Guess what? She said her sister was having confidence, telling her, yes, I did it.
Really?
Do whatever you want, yes. Your own sister. She felt more sad. That's why she emailed back. She said she felt more sad. The only person she could think about is to call her mom back home. You know, what mama is going to tell you?
Don't sue your sister. That's your blood sister. Remember, you suck the same.
Same stomach. Please don't do anything to your mom, to your sister. Please, please. Your mom, she said her mom promised to pay back. How?
Seriously.
How? Our mom told me
about your sister.
It's not a loving mother. It's not a loving mother, guys, but it's serious, serious. It's serious. Her mom, she, the guy, I feel the lady's email, and that's why I brought it up today. I said, they say our mom told her, please do not call police on your mom. Because in America, the first thing people think about is to call the police, right? So our mom said, do not call the police on your mom. The dad was begging her, please don't call the police on your sister. Please don't do it.
Remember, your sister stood up for you when you're going there.
They started reminding you, the good things your sisters have done to you. This is only one thing. But they don't understand, this is over $15,000. That's a lot of money.
But seriously, does that, standing up for someone, does that justify you to do what she did?
Whatever you want.
Does that just justify you to exploit me?
Because I don't know the reason. I'm like, no, no. So finally, she didn't do anything. She said she stayed. Unfortunately, this year she was forced to stay. I'm sorry, whoever was sending me this email, I'm not laughing, but this situation. She was forced to stay in mom, in that sister house.
Yeah, you have
for
no
6 months again. They are not talking. But she has no choice. She was forced to stay there 6 months and this defend her woman. She moved out and she started paying her loan. But now here she ended up saying, I finished paying the loan. I'm okay. I'm happy. But my advice to everybody is please, please, please do not trust anybody when it comes to your documents. Always check your documents. Nobody's using them so that nobody's going to mess up with your life.
I think the other thing that should come up is if you don't, you know, when you play in the green card, the green card don't choose who wins. Everybody wants to win. And let me tell you one thing. Most people, like 90% of people who want to win the green card, they don't even have the resources to come.
Yeah.
They don't have money. Mm-hmm. Let me tell you, this is a fact. Like, you play, you win. When you win, that's when it dawns to you, I need money to go there. I need someone to host me. Since you're so desperate, anyone who comes to your help, you're there.
You take it.
You take it. Which, it's okay. It's okay to take it. But I think what people don't like to hear, but I have to tell you this. Don't like free things. If someone tells you, I'm here, I'll stand up for you, I'll pay for you, be sure to ask, talk to that person, and promise to pay back. Let me tell you, there's nothing free here. There's nothing free.
Nothing.
If someone tells you, I can help you, or if you want to ask someone, oh, please, help me. When I come there, I will settle and I will promise
to
pay back. If you promise to pay back,
please
just
pay back.
Pay back. Because most people are like, who does he or she think I am? Am I going to kill my back to keep this one person comfortable? I'm going to kill my back to get this person from whom to bring her. It pains, let me tell you.
Even
it's
your
painful.
Own sister? No.
Promise. You know, we are different. We are all different. We are different. That's why I say, say it. Tell them. Tell them I'll pay you however you want. But if that person chooses not to be paid, fine. At that point, if someone expects a payment, that person will tell you, fine, it's okay. When you come, we'll talk. But if someone expects you to pay back, and you don't pay, that's why they are pushed to do such things. They are pushed to do that same.
But
such
set me down. I'm your sister. Tell me, sister.
It doesn't matter.
No, you maybe she didn't ask. She didn't ask her.
That's why she didn't ask.
No, no. This is sister. I think you are kind of giving the credit to the one who's still.
No, 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 no.
Number one, she could have sit down with her sister, young sister, tell her, my sister.
Now put it out.
I use this man here. To bring
no, put it clean
please
before
pay
you
me
come.
Back. If I say no, then you can go use your
no,
documents.
No, 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 no. Put it back, point blank, before you leave your country.
No, no.
No, don't make use of. Don't come to blame with me.
But this is my sister.
It doesn't
matter. You just say, for example, since my sister, you brought me here. When I'm back there, I don't know. You know, when we are back in our country, we don't know what's going on here.
Yeah.
We are black. Especially when you get in here, then you don't know left and right. You don't know south, north. You don't know anything. You only know the gate to get to the garage and down to the house.
I'm just That's saying what this. You know. I say this.
If you want me to pay back, if you want me to
We are different. We are different, right? We are different. Guys, people please. Are different. I'm trying
Help
to even out.
I understand. No. If you want me to pay you back, sat me down and tell me, young sister, sweetie, honey, please.
That's what I'm saying. Say.
And if I say no, don't use my documents to get you what you want.
That's what I'm saying. She did not say it should come from the person who needs. I'm the one in need.
So
she's in
from
America.
Me?
She's in America. She's not. She doesn't need anything. It's me who needs someone to host me and keep me.
But this is my sister.
Your sister. You have yes. Yes, it's your sister, but you have responsibilities. That's what's killing people down.
Yes, when I'm back there, I don't know that responsibility. I think my sister is in America. She has a lot of money. She can help me.
That's a perception.
Sister. But once I got here, I see a different story, right, guys? Please agree with me. I see a different story. After that, sat me down.
No.
Tell me, my sister, when you were back there, get a pen, get a paper. When you were back there, this is how much I used.
It's not even half.
Can you even pay a half? Don't take my document.
I'm not paying a half. Listen, that's why I said before you get there, I have to make you understand money does not grow on trees. Here.
When I'm there, I will not understand.
No,
wait
I have
until
to
I get here and then
no,
I will understand.
I don't want to come and understand. It's before you lift your leg to get in that plane, you need to know what responsibilities you're coming to. I'll give you an ultimatum, let me tell you. Number one, if I pay anything for you, if I wanted to pay, I'll give you a receipt. This is much I paid. If I paid for your ticket, this is much I paid. If I pay for rent, this is, you know, people push people to do things that they don't want to do. I can pay you for you 5,000. But I might demand from you 2,500. But if you push me that much, you're gonna pay to the cent. The day you come to my house, I tell you, okay, 1, 2, 3, and you go get a job first, salary, second salary, that salary out.
Hey,
and I give you your document.
My sister.
Yes.
That's my own sister. Same stomach.
It's not about stomach. Same stomach, yes, but let me tell you, you came on your time, I came on my time. We were not twins. Even if we were twins. You have your life, I have my life. That's the economy.
Guys, green cards are coming out next year. Please, think twice. Be positive. You're going to win.
Yes.
Who do you want to host you? You want to be hosted with who? If you have a family members, put X on them. Get a stranger. A stranger will do perfect. Don't you think a stranger will help you?
Yeah, a stranger. Let me tell you, stranger. You know that's why I'm saying that. You know why strangers do good? Let me tell you why strangers do good. Why people do good with strangers? Because this person
does not know you.
Does not know you. Number two, you have that respect.
Just
that if I get
respect.
Anything free from this person, this is an open person, and I appreciate it. But that sister brother thing, that's what kills.
Everything.
Because
you think it's my sister.
It's my sister. You owed to give me some things for free. No.
So you think this sister did it good? Eh?
No. This is what I'm saying. She did not do good, right?
Mm-hmm.
She did not do good. But the what she missed on is before you leave back home.
No. Once you get here, that's when you get the picture what's going on. Let's say now, guys, please. Let's say now I'm standing.
Me, let me tell you, I didn't have a sister anywhere, but the person I talked to, she told me life here is hard. Life here is hard.
It's not easy.
It's not easy. So you have to put it
to them. No matter what you do, no matter who you are, it's not easy.
I might get a job, a good job with good money, but I have kids, you know? I would love to work so many days and have good money, but maybe I have kids, I can only work for so few days. To be able to pay for the bills, I can't get extra money. But if someone, you tell someone like that, life is hard here, even back home, someone should understand. You know, you cannot take the picture to them.
They won't see it.
That's what I said. Whether they like it or not, tell them. When they come here, they see the real picture. Because when you're coming up, you're not so expectant, like, oh, I'm go get money from wherever. No, you know, if you know I have to work for anything, if I know you cannot even get free pressure for your car, you pay. Yeah, in Africa we get that free, you know. Here you pay for pressure for the car. I tell people I pay even the pressure. If my car gets a flat tire, even if it's just pressure, nothing else, I have to pack with something to feel the pressure. But you have to put it out right. People should not be too expectant. Put it out there.
I expect
you should not have high expectation. So I'm not advocating for what the sister did. She did wrong. But how could this be avoided? It could have been avoided. The reason she felt justified is because she felt you needed to pay back something.
But I asked the lady on the email, I'm like, did your sister ask you to pay her the money back? She says she never asked it.
Yeah.
Did you hover?
Did you ask?
Did you hover? I say, sister, you know, how much did you, I see life here is so hard, how much did you use on
no, YouTube? She's my sister.
There you go.
I'm sorry.
She's my sister.
It's so bad, like, here and back home is different. I can be my sister, we share one mother, but my different father, so... Get it, I have different genes. You have different genes. So
that's my sister. Okay.
So please, I'm trying just to bring something up and I'm trying to...
It's true. That's
what happens.
It happens a lot. It really, really happens a lot. So guys, when you come into Austria, be careful.
Sleep with your document.
Put them under the pillow.
Yes.
At the middle of the night when you go to the bathroom, you touch them at day 10. Tomorrow in the morning, put them here.
Because
you're walking around the house, walk them here.
Yeah, when you come, when you're very new, you don't see the essence of those documents.
You don't.
You only think you only need them for to look for a job, and that's it. No.
That's your life.
It's not. That's your life. That's if your you life. Ever want to progress in life, at one point you want to buy your, you want to buy like your car, you want to buy your house, you want to buy this. That's what they ask for.
That's when it comes up. Even if you want to rent. And if you are not going to stay in your sister house, whoever is hosting you forever. One time you want to start your own family. One time you want to kupanga.
Yeah, they put things together. And then you want to have, you know when you always have big plans before we come here, until we come here and see the reality. But yeah, when when you face the reality, it's good to have the resources ready. Don't go to be shocked someone took $100,000 in your name and then you have a bad credit because you don't pay it. Why? Number one, you don't even know you have that loan.
And the reason to the people at workplace, be friendly, talk about it. Talk. You know, your state's not going to tell you everything. The people, the person who's hosting you in the house is 1 out of 100 want to give you all the information. So when you are working there, be open, talk to people. This agency could not find out somebody's using a credit card until she said a co-worker.
And number one, most people say credit card. I don't need a credit card. Why do I need it for?
Yeah, that's what even asked us how we started.
That's how you do. That's what people say. You think it's loans, but it kind of
just help you.
It kind of opens you up. It kind of gets you to know your status here. It gets to test, lets you know, okay, when I go to apply, when they put the number, they run your credit, they see how much you owe. They say you don't know anything, you're like, oh, thanks.
Yeah.
But so, you might be, people have been surprised.
Yeah, even your own husband.
Yes.
Your own wife. Your wife.
And then you ask them, you're like, oh, you don't give me money. That's why I took it.
And it's even better a stranger to surprise me than my own partner, my own sister.
But surprisingly, do you know mostly strangers, they steal when you go to the store. They can steal your card and then maybe use it to pay, but you are
they're not gonna steal that much.
Siblings don't steal hundreds, my friend. siblings don't steal
husbands,
hundreds.
Wives, they steal millions.
They don't steal hundreds. They steal from 1, 2, 20, 30 thousand. Tens and about.
They wanna pull you down.
Yeah, because they wanna do it once and for all. Not this stranger who does 5, 10, 15 because he wanna keep doing it. No. This person will do once. And for all.
So when it comes to host, find out anybody, if you have a friend, whatever, somebody who you can trust with your documents. That's very, very important. And before we close, I'm going to give big thank you to whoever hosted me when I came to this country.
Oh yeah, me too.
I was fine. I didn't see when I was in that house, but after I left, I really, really appreciate you guys. is two people who hosted me. I appreciate them, and I'm looking forward to finding them. So guys, thank you so much. Have a good night. Have a good morning, wherever you are, whatever you are watching by. Thank you. Bye.
Story time.